boxing legend, Arturo Gatti, when he passed away in 2009, at first they said it was suicide, that he hung himself. Now, after a 10-month investigation, they're saying that it was murder. The only person at the time at the apartment in Brazil was his wife. I'm here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard. Robert, you were supposed to fight Arturo Gatti, right?
Well, at one time I was ranked number one in the IBF, yeah, and then he moved up in weight and the title was vacant, so that's when I won the vacant IBF title, yeah.
What do you say, that he was murdered? It's something that everybody kind of knew.
I thought, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong, but I thought couple months ago I read that that special investigators, you know, went through investigation and said that it was suicide, but now, that's the first time I hear that. I don't even know, but if it was, it's fucked up.
He has $6 million in the bank. The wife is fighting with the family. The family saying that's the oldest motive in history when someone kills someone for gain, for profit. I mean, what do you remember him as a fighter? Do you remember his fights, what he meant to the game?
We all remember his fights, especially the ones against Ward, his fights against, he had great fights. He fought Mayweather, lost to Mayweather. He lost to Alfonso Gomez, but that was towards the end of
his
career.
That was his last fight, I think.
But he had some great fights, since he was, against Ruela. A really good fight, and he had great ones. If I think about it, I probably remember a lot of them, but right now, those are the ones that came up to my mind, but they were all good.
Brandon, you said that you want to be like Arturo Gatti when you fight. Why?
Yeah.
Why?
I have the similar style of Arturo Gatti.
He didn't move his head either?
He didn't move his head like people wanted to move his head, but
he was a warrior.
He was a warrior. And look at that. Look what he's done in boxing. He's done a lot. So, people are like that. People's going to hate all the time, but Arturo Gatti, I always wanted to be like him. Arturo Gatti, Diego Corrales.
But he's like you, Castillo. Because he was very, very popular. People loved watching him no matter what.
I'm not popular, so he wasn't like me.
Everybody knows who you are.
I like him, if that's okay.
Yeah. Doesn't everybody know Brandon Rios? Will you go with him places?
Yeah, a lot of people do know him, but it's still not his time. It'll come after a couple more fights.
I do it slowly. I'm not into a rush to get fame. I'm not into a rush to try to make more money. I'm comfortable and happy with the money I'm making right now, so why rush it?
So what's your favorite fight or knockout of Arturo Gatti that comes to mind when someone mentions it?
My favorite fight is with him and Ward. That's the favorite.
Which one?
All of them was good. The first one and the third one, they all were good.
Would you want to fight someone 3 times if you could?
Yeah, fuck, if I can. So you give me a good fight like that, yeah. Actually, I thought me and Antonio was going to be something like that. But Antonio, I guess he couldn't take the punches. And that's the only reason why he couldn't. He just couldn't take the punches.
I asked Marquez, Juan Manuel Marquez, yesterday if he wants to fight you.
What did he say?
He said right now he's focused about one person and one
so that's
person
a no.
only. He said Manny Pacquiao.
That's a no.
I guess. But that would be a good fight.
When I'm focused on somebody, I still say I like to fight that person. I don't give a fuck. But it's just different people. Marquez, I love the fight. Manny, I love the fight.
You and Pacquiao, good fight?
That'll be a good fight. I'm not going to be drained. I'm going to be going up weight, and I won't be drained. So
that's better.
And he's 25. He'll be 26.
He'll be 26, and Pacquiao will be 35, 36.
Not only that,
how old is Pacquiao right now?
He's 31.
He'll be 32. Still, he'll be 26,
and I'll be going away. The way I've been training, Robert's been training, the second training class I've been doing, I've been working my ass off. Henry helps me out a lot, too. I do good work with them. So, just gonna get more experience, I'll be ready. A little more experience.
There you have it, right here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard.
Arturo Gatti is the best.
Reporting. What?
Arturo Gatti is the best, though. He's the man. I love that guy. Him and Diego Corrales. Those two guys I looked up to.
Both of them passed away.
Yeah, those two guys I looked up to.
But there's the thing. Gatti needs justice. I mean, if he was murdered, they have to bring the people responsible for justice.
It's happening over there, so there's nothing we can do about it. Nobody can do about it. But like I said, even though all that incident, whatever happened, Arturo Gatti and Diego Corrales are my... That's what I look up to.
Very exciting fighters.
Oh, yeah.
They just come forward like you.
Same like Chavez. Senior. Same way. I look up to those guys like that. Badass fighters.